So if you've ever tried to find a Chrome extension to help with SEO, you can actually find that it's pretty overwhelming. In today's video, I'm gonna go through the top 10 SEO Chrome extensions for you to use, and trust me, you're going to want to use these as you're performing keyword research or even just SEO research for a campaign. So stay tuned, we're gonna cover that in this video. All right, welcome back and thank you for joining me. My name is Jordan Steen, also known as Serial Entrepreneur. And at this channel, we talk all about starting a marketing agency, building a personal brand, or really just building any kind of online business. So if you're interested in any of those topics I just mentioned, then make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that way you get updated with all of our future videos, free trainings, and giveaways that we do here at my channel. Now, the cool thing is if you're a Google user, like most of you are, and if you're not, then I strongly suggest downloading Google Chrome as a web browser and using it because of the simple fact that they've created this really cool feature called Chrome plugins. And what these plugins essentially allow you to do is add tools to basically any web browser or any Chrome web browser that you're using, and it gives you different functionalities. And especially for SEO, it allows you to look at different features of the website and how it's performing. And we're gonna show you 10 tools in this video that you're definitely going to want to use. But before we do that, I want to tell you guys to make sure you stay tuned to the end of this video because we're going to give you 4 tools that are going to help you increase your search traffic by 50% at the very least. If you're using these tools properly, you're going to get more traffic to your site. So stay tuned to the end. We'll talk about that too. All right, guys. So the app number one, or the first app we want to go through for these Chrome extensions, is Buzzsumo. And what it essentially does is if you're looking for ways to create content or who to even gather content from, this gives you a quick look at that. So you can go to a web page and just click the Chrome extension, and it's actually going to show you the total amount of engagements on each social platform, and then the Evergreen score and the number of links it's been backlinked out to, or how many links have been backlinked. Then you can always click analyze website and go over, it'll direct you over to Buzzsumo's site where they'll put it through the content analyzer and it'll pull up a ton of information and data for you to look at. Buzzsumo's Chrome extension, number one free download out there for SEO. Definitely check out this tool. Tool number two that we're going to go into is SEOQuake, and you can see this tool right here. It actually shows you several different things. So it'll show you general page info, how it ranks with Alexa, Google, Bing, SEMrush, Web Archive. The subdomain backlinks. There's tons of different places where you can rank your site, and this shows how you are indexed or ranked on each site for specific keywords in your niche. Now, again, keep in mind, these are the free tools, so these aren't 100% accurate. And even if you're paying for the paid version, it's not 100% accurate. So there is some discrepancies, but just know that it does give you a general idea. So Facebook likes, you can see, is at 1.7. If we pulled up Buzzsumo, like we just went into, you guys can see we have about 1.7 engagements right there. And that's about how many people have liked your page. That's what that is right there. So pretty cool tool. But again, the SEOQuake tool is really cool. You can look at internal breakdowns of your site, external breakdowns of your site, density on keywords and things of that nature, and showing how popular that or how prominent that keyword is, whether it's a header tag, whether it's actually found in the meta description, and whether it's found in the title. All of these things are important information that you want to be tracking as you're building your SEO and as you're starting to try and rank specific keywords. And really quickly, guys, just a quick tip. SEO for mobile is making a huge difference in how you should actually be optimizing your websites along with voice search. So if you're looking for information on that, you're going to want to check out this video we put together in the top right hand corner. The third tool we're going to go into is Check My Links. And you can see that it actually shows all of the different places on a website where there are links. Basically a redirect if you're using redirect links or if you have invalid links. Now, again, these are free tools. So I want to show you guys, for example, it says invalid links too, right? Number one, I couldn't even find the second invalid link. Number two is it's saying that my Twitter link is invalid, but if you click it open, you can clearly see that it's going to take you to a web page that is valid, right? So you can't, again, always rely on these 100%. Like even up here, it was saying just a second ago, it was caching these as false. Now you can see they're actually valid links. So again, don't take it 100%, but this is something where you can go into a website, do a quick analysis, and it will point out things that are wrong. I'm not going to say that it's just always wrong, because it's definitely not. It is a useful tool, and it will point out things on a website, or really links on a website that are broken. And these are things that you can take to a business owner and say, look, these are all the links on your site that are broken. Your web developer isn't doing this. You should let us manage your website. Another one of my favorite tools is going to be keywords everywhere. So if I typed in social media marketing course, what keywords everywhere does is a few things. You can see all of these are related keywords to social media marketing course, social media marketing certification, training courses, courses for business, best social media marketing courses, right? All of these are search keywords that are related to this. So I can look at these and start looking at whether I want to add these to my strategy, right? Another cool thing is for this specific keyword, it tells you the volume, the cost per click, and the competition in pay-per-click in this industry for this specific keyword. So it's a really cool tool to do quick analysis of a set of keywords and say, should we add this to our campaign or should we avoid it? You know, it's just a really great tool that shows all kinds of information about keywords and specific keywords that you might be targeting for your campaigns. Oh, and quick break. I want to ask you guys something. What is it that you find most complicated about SEO? What is it that you either don't understand or is holding you back from really learning SEO even more in depth? If you have something, please leave it in the comments below this video. I'd like to know so that way we can help you out. All right, guys, the next Chrome extension we want to show you is called Page Analytics. And all it is Google Analytics, Google Chrome extension. And that's all you guys can see right here at the very top. It's showing page views, unique page views, on time, average time on page, bounce rate, and then exit rate, average time on page for this specific page, which makes sense. It should be lower. They're not going to spend a ton of time on the homepage because they're trying to get to the resources that they came there for, right? So when they go to another page, that's when it starts counting the average time on that page, right? And then the exit rate from that page, the specific bounce rate from that page. And then what's even cooler than that is it shows you all of these little percentages are how many times that an average user is coming and clicking on one of these links right here, right? So it shows every single link on my homepage and which ones are getting clicked on. So this is something for me to be able to look at and say, okay, well, these links are working. These links aren't. Should we change this up? Should we change the call to action? Why isn't this working, right? But this is a really cool tool to help you analyze a site quickly and easily, and also let you know what you should be changing as far as maybe copy, call to action placement, all of those different things. Tool number six is Google Tag Assistant. Now, personally, at Serial Entrepreneur, we don't use tags on our website, but if you do use Google Tags, then this will be a cool tool for you to see where tags are placed, if they're functioning properly. Basically, like the Facebook Pixel Checker, if you guys have ever used that tool, it kind of shows you if they're functioning or if they're not, and allows you to go back to your team and say, hey, we need to update these tags and make sure that they're functioning. So, Google Tag Manager, if you're using Google Tags, really great for you too. The seventh tool we're going to talk about is Evernote Web Clipper, which I recently found out is a pretty cool new tool, or at least it's a cool new tool to me. But Evernote Web Clipper allows you to take snapshots of web pages and save them in Evernote. So if you use Evernote to store notes about things, you could use it for a client. Say you have a client that works in the home remodeling industry. You could actually use it to take images of different home remodeling websites and store it all under that one note. So let me show you how it works. Basically, you open up Evernote Web Clipper, you click on save in media, basically. So I'll show you what it looks like when you open it up. You click save clip on a web page, right? And then when you log into your Evernote, it's actually going to have that web page saved right here with the link and everything that was on that web page. So pretty cool, right? Because it also took the title of the page, social media marketing courses, serial entrepreneur, Jordan Steen, right? That was the title of that web page. And it actually took it, added it as the title of this note in Evernote, and also made it as a screenshot so that way we could see what was included on that page. The eighth tool we want to talk about is called Redirect Path. A redirect path actually shows you if you have any links on your page that are not redirecting properly. It looks for 301s, 302s, 404s, 500 links, all kinds of different links that you could have on your site or redirect links. And if they're functioning improperly, then it lets you know and says, hey, you need to go check that out, right? So really cool tool to also take down some information about your site and your on-page SEO performance. So the ninth tool is called Grammarly. A lot of you have heard of this tool, but if you're not using it for your websites, then you probably are missing out on a few things. Number one, because it's going to help you with spell check, right? That is the basics. Spell check and grammar, great. But it also tells you which words you're repeating too often, right? You don't want to use words too many times, especially your keywords, because search engines will actually penalize you for that, right? So it tells you, you know, whether you're using it too much or whether it's the right amount. Grammarly, though, really great tool, super easy to use, and it pretty much works on any web browser. It works on any web page that you're using inside of the Google Chrome web browser. Now, the 10th and final tool we want to talk to you guys about is going to be Mozbar. And Mozbar shows you several different things with regards to on-page elements, general page attributes, link metrics, markups, and then any HTTP statuses like those redirects we were talking about if you might have errors. It also shows your PA and your DA, which is your domain authority, your spam rank or your spam score, which is basically 1%, which is good for us. But it shows you a ton of different metrics about web pages and how the page is performing, the URL, the title of the page, all kinds of different stuff, right? So this is a really cool thing because you can see right here, meta description not found, meta keywords not found. And we know that it's not because this is one of our older articles from 2017. We're not really too worried about it. But with all of our newer articles, you would go in and see that we do have meta descriptions. We do have meta keywords. We do have H2s and H1 tags. And that's going to help search engines find our sites better. But this tool allows you to look and check out those elements on a web page very, very simply. But that's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed those 10 tools. If you want some more information about any of those tools in depth, then you're going to want to check out our blog article. So make sure you go right below this video in the description. Check for the section on the left-hand side in the description. It'll say blog. And then that link right to the right of that will be our blog article. But you can go check that out. We went in depth on each one of these tools even more there. Finally, I told you guys that if you stayed till the end of the video, we would give you some more tools to help you start basically increasing your traffic by at least 50% with search engine traffic. So all you have to do is check out this video in the top right-hand corner, and it goes into four tools that we use on a regular basis that we didn't necessarily cover in this video. But that's it for me, everybody. If you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification bell, because we put together updates like this 4 times per week. We do live trainings, we do giveaways every single week, and you want to get updated, so make sure to hit that button. But I'm getting out of here, guys. So until the next video, Serial Entrepreneur out. Later, guys.
Ready to start living the six-figure, work wherever, be your own boss lifestyle? Well, at Serial Entrepreneur Academy, we'll teach you how to use a laptop and internet to start your own social media and digital marketing agency. Get started with our free Facebook ads training. Links in the description below, guys. See you in the course. Serial Entrepreneur out.